Meteor showers are rare and they can be hard to see. So it's not many people have had an amazing experience of seeing them in their full glory, but that is about to change. A Japanese startup is creating new technology that will actually create meteor showers. It's hoping to turn controlled meteor showers into big business for aerospace entertainment. It's scheduled its first big public event for next year. Joining me now via Skype from Tokyo, Japan, is Josh Rodenbaugh, who works in the company's satellite operations department. Josh, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
All right, this is such a big question. I'm just going to serve you up one-word questions. Why?
Okay. So why? Well, our founder, Lina Okajima, she grew up in a rural part of Japan, and she frequently got to see shooting stars as a child. She then went on to Tokyo University and got her PhD in astronomy. And this is something that she has always wanted to share with people. It's a big passion for her. And there is science value to what we're doing. There's obviously entertainment value to what we're doing. But a big part of what we want to do is inspire. We want to get people looking up. And if we can get even one child to look up and see our shooting stars and think, how did they do that? And be inspired to enter maybe aerospace, but also any STEM field, then that's something that would be very meaningful to us.
All right, Josh, well, you just served up my next question. How is this even possible? How does the technology work?
So what we do is we send up satellites to low Earth orbit with several hundred of our shooting star particles. We then release those particles one by one where they burn up in the atmosphere like natural shooting stars, but much, much better. And this allows customers to call us up and order a meteor shower on demand. And if you think about natural shooting stars, they're mostly the size of grains of sand or specks of dust. They move very, very fast at around 12 to 20 kilometers a second. And they're made up of all sorts of different materials that are just floating around out there. Our shooting stars will be larger, about a centimeter in diameter. They'll move relatively slower at about 7.5 kilometers a second. And we choose the materials. What this means is that our shooting stars will move slower across the sky, they'll burn longer, and they'll burn much, much brighter, even brightly enough to see within a major city like Tokyo.
Wow. Now, how would someone order this? How do you customize something like this? And let's say I was in the market for something like this, what would something like this cost me?
Well, we don't have a price point set yet. Most of our business will be business to business. There's probably not too many individuals that can call us up on their own and order one of these. But it is something that in the future, we hope to get more satellites up with more particles and bring the cost down somewhat.
Now, a lot of news has been made in the past few years about this notion of space junk and just things floating around in near space. Will something like this contribute to space junk and chemicals burning up in the atmosphere?
No, absolutely not. We release very, very precisely, and we control where the particles re-enter. And if you think of space, space begins around 100 kilometers. Our particles will start burning visibly around 80 kilometers, and they will be completely gone by 60 kilometers. So there's absolutely no space debris created.
What sort of testing do you need to do? Like you say that you control this. How much control can you really have over something like this when we're talking about the speeds that we're talking about and the scope of distance that we're talking about as well?
Well, we do testing in two different areas. One would be, of course, our particles and the materials that they're made of. But as far as controlling it goes, to stay in orbit, you have to be at a certain speed. And if you slow down, then you actually drop very, very quickly. And so simply by slowing the particles down when we release them from the satellite, we can actually, from release to re-entry, it can be as short as 15 minutes.
Oh, wow. All right, so Josh, let's assume everything goes well. Let's assume that you hit all the benchmarks you want to hit. When is the first time that people on the ground are going to be able to look up and be awed by this technology?
Sometime next year in 2019, we hope to have two satellites going up late this year and early next year. And then we hope to have our first events in mid to late 2019.
Josh, this sounds really exciting. Anytime someone's pushing the envelope like this, I'm cheering them on. So we wish you the very best with this.
Thank you.